Hi everyone, welcome to my art studio. My name is Sherry, for those that don't know me, and I've been doing the in-person classes for over 10 years now, which is crazy. I can't believe it's been that long, but I absolutely love doing the classes, and we've had so much fun with them, and I've met a lot of really cool people along the way. And I've always wanted to do a Facebook Live paint demo, so kind of chickened out with that. So I'm gonna start with just doing a video, and then starting in March, I'm gonna start doing the Facebook Live videos at least twice a month. And I'll create an event so that you know what days and what paintings we're gonna be doing. And I'll also send out emails. And with that, you'll have the option to download the supply list and your paint colors and an outline of what we'll be painting that particular day. I try to keep all my paintings simple so that people that have never picked up a paintbrush can create a piece of art that they are excited about and can display it in their home. It makes a cute decoration. Several years ago, I quit using canvas at the classes and started buying these 11 by 17 boards at Michael's. You can order these online also, but I love the hard surface, and I love that you don't necessarily have to deal with the background if you don't want to. So it makes it a little bit easier. The other thing is that I try to tell everybody just to relax, don't overthink it, and have fun, because it's art and it should be fun. And you'll find if you do them more often, it's easier to obtain that. And the other cool thing is that you start to pick up your own little style. I'm not going to chit-chat too much, so I think we should just get busy with the fun part. I'm going to bring this over here so you can see what I'm doing. I think you can see it. Bring him over. So I basically use three brushes when I'm doing the classes. Okay, well there's four, but typically I use the half inch flat brush. I use the flat brushes for everything. I love them. And then I just want a smaller round brush and a liner brush to do an outline at the end. I try to get all my paint so everything is set up and I don't have to stop in the middle of it and run and get things. I also recommend that you wear a smock because it's really hard to get the paint out if you get it on your clothes. I obviously don't care because I have paint on everything. This is a simple paint palette. We're just using titanium white, yellow, red, and brown. And I'm gonna start by dipping into my white, and then I'm gonna dip into my brown. Our base colors, I like them to be a little bit darker, so then when we go back in and add the highlights, they pop more. Ooh, I just dipped into my black. Don't want black yet. So you don't have to really, this doesn't have to be perfect because we're gonna go back in and add some more layers to it. But I definitely don't want it to be stark white. And if you're using the boards, I kind of run my brush down the cracks. So I'm just picking out everything that's going to be white and doing the brown. I also try to figure out where my light source is coming from. So I'm going to pretend that it's coming from this side. So I want the highlights to kind of be on that side. So I'm going to make this side of him a little bit darker by adding a little more brown. It is. And you're always welcome to change colors to match your own decor or taste. I tend to do my brush strokes in the direction of the object. I use chalk to outline this just so you would be able to see it easily on the video. And so I try to paint over any chalk marks, but if you miss some after the painting is completely dry, you can just go over it with a wet paper towel, and all those chalk marks will disappear. And don't be afraid to load your brush. You don't want it too thick because you want it to dry. Before we start layering up the highlights, we want the base coat to be pretty dry. I'm gonna go ahead and make my snow. And see, I'm running that horizontal. I don't care if some of the wood shines through. It doesn't have to be covered 100%. I kind of like it when the wood comes through. The other cool thing is if you make a mistake, sometimes that ends up being the best part of the painting. You can usually figure out some way to do something cool with it. I'm gonna do this little brim here. Miss anything. So next, I'm not even going to clean up my brush. I'm just going to scoop some brown and dip into my black. I want to get a dark brown. And you can use your flat brush, or you can switch to your round brush now. Depending on what you're comfortable with. But I'm gonna start with my brush flat, and then I kind of twist it up sideways. I want his arms to be thicker at the base. I'm just gonna do a little swish. And let's see, we're gonna start this arm up here. We want it so the cardinal is sitting on his hand, so. But I try to make it real thin at the end and thicker at the base. Then we can just go straight into our black now. Which is cool, the black will wipe out anything, so you don't really have to clean your brush in between. And I'm gonna base coat his hat. Doing the classes, it really is fun to watch how everyone's turns out a little bit different just from their brush strokes. Sometimes it inspires me. How did you do that? up most of my chalk. Do his rim, and I'm just going to keep the brush flat and just drag it straight across. A little bit of water to that. It's nice. I think the paint dries faster on the wood also. But you can paint on absolutely anything you want, any surface. And if you're just starting out, you don't have to buy expensive paints. So there you go. Check. If I get a thick spot, I kind of will just use my finger to spread it out so it dries quicker. A highly technical technique. So I'm going to clean my brush out, then I'll just dry it off with my pants. But you can use a paper towel. I'm going to, now that this is pretty much dry, and it's a little wet still, I'm going to go in and just dip into my straight white, and I'm going to start just doing some quick brush strokes. And I'm doing them kind of in a curve. Trying not to get into your black. And as I come around to the other side, like I said, I want it to look like the light is kind of over shining this way. I'm just going to dip into my brown a little bit. So I want to lighten that, but I also want it to still be a little bit darker than the other side. I get into my little banner there. It's okay. We can cover that with the red. Dip into my brown again because I want to kind of tone this down on this side. And I'm going to go ahead and do the snow underneath him. I'm just going to do quick brush strokes because I kind of like it when the wood shines through a little bit. we can always go back in and add a little more white. And go ahead and do his. Trying to make sure, I'm not sure my black is completely dry up there, so trying to be careful. Add a little bit of brown on this end. Ah! How did I get into my red? Okay, where's my paper towel? That was a definite no-no. So we're just gonna wet a paper towel and kind of swish that off. We're gonna let that dry and then I'll go over it with the brown. Gotta watch your paint palette there. So next I think we'll go ahead and do, we're gonna definitely go back over the white again, but I'm gonna mix my pink. You can just do red and white, but I kinda like the orangey red. So I add a little bit of yellow to my red. If you want it to be your banner and your hearts and stuff to be red, I would take this mixture here and add a touch of black because I want my base coat to be dark. Red is a little hard to cover. So if you start with a dark red, then when you add the white to the red, it'll pop a lot more. So I'm gonna scoop into my white because I'm gonna stick with the pink. I want my first coat to be a darker pink. I think that'll work. And I'm gonna start I'm just gonna outline the banners to kind of give me a guideline. And I kind of put them at a curve. With the flat brushes, when I'm filling in, I'll use them laying flat, but when I'm kind of outlining and trying to get into smaller areas, I keep the brush upright. So I can do a little more detail, I guess, but you can also switch to a smaller brush if you're more comfortable with that. I don't always mix my paint up completely on my palette either. I kind of like to blend the colors or mix them right on the board. Go ahead and get our base coat of our little cardinals. Remember, it's chubby. Then I'm gonna just do a quick swish for his tail. For the birds, you might want to use your smaller brush. I paint all the time, so I can kind of control it pretty well. I was trying to debate if I wanted to move the heart up, but I think I'll leave it on his brim. You can take a piece of chalk if you want to check out, but kind of do a little rough outline for a guideline if you want. Try to keep it off the crack. I love these boards, but the cracks can be a kind of a pain sometimes. Base coat his nose. And once again, I try to do the face so it's not on the crack. And you can do a carrot nose too. Totally up to you. So I'm gonna clean out my brush again. I think the white has had a chance to dry more. I'm gonna wipe it off. And then I'm gonna go in with my straight white again and just add some brush strokes of the white to give it. Try not to get into your nose. I'm just gonna keep taking my brush back because it won't have too much paint on it by the time I get to this side. Just to give it a little bit more. I'm just gonna add some white, one more layer of white over here. You don't have to cover it completely. It's nice to leave the base coats shine through, and like I said, even the wood shining through, I like that look. Just a little bit more. I'm kind of add a little here. I think this is dry. Fix my little snafu. If you have to paint back over something, let it dry, because 9 times out of 10, if you don't, it just starts to get muddy. So I'm going to check my pink. Again, and then I'm gonna add more white to the pink that I mixed up earlier. And I'm gonna put my second coat. I'm gonna leave some of the dark on the outside, but you can paint it solid if you want. The second coat definitely covers better. can decide if you want to go back over it again. Now I'm going to go back over here, start adding some highlights. Forgot his tail. I'm going to add a little more red. I'm going to save some of that. I want a little bit of the darker. And come in and make it darker underneath him. So we want the birds to dry. We can now go back and dip into your brown and add a little bit of white. And I'm just gonna add some highlights on his. And I keep them like the sun is coming this direction, so I want the highlight to be on the right side. And I just want to do a little swish on top of the branch. Go ahead and now we can go into our black again. I don't know if you want to, if you need a second coat, the black usually covers pretty good. But I'm going to do a quick second coat just so it'll give a chance for the birds to dry. So then I'm going to still have the black in my brush, but I'm going to dip the corner of it into some white and add some highlights on the side of his hat. Put some there on his hat. Back into that pink. And I'm going to have pink on my brush, but I'm going to load white again on the, just on the corner. And I'm going to add a little highlight on his nose. And if you're happy with, you know, if you, the paint on his head, or if you're happy with the white, I use the back of my paintbrush to do the small dots for his eyes. Sure enough. Obviously you can do bigger eyes or different kinds of eyes if you'd like, but let's test that out. So I just use the back of my brush and do little dots. When you're not using your brush that you've been painting with, I always just throw it in my water because sometimes it doesn't take the paint long to dry in them, and that totally ruins the brush. So now we're going to go back to our birds, and I'm gonna take my small brush. Depending on what paint you're using, you can sometimes you add some white, or add some water, I mean, to thin it out so it flows a little better. So try to keep the cardinals simple, but I just do like a teardrop. For his face. I'm looking at the little highlight here, it's not that. I'm going to go back over the cardinal's wings. Just kind of dip in. And I'm going to add some white to the corner of my brush. Kind of, you know, step back and see if you need to go back over anything at this point. And go ahead and add a little highlights on the side of the heart too. We want the cardinals to dry. While we're waiting on that, we can see if your banner is dry. It's still got some wet on it. Well, we can start outlining some of it while we wait for that to dry. Outlining it is totally up to you. I love to outline my things because I just feel like it makes it pop, but I also like the look of not outlining. So, but when I do outline, I'm going to use a smaller liner brush, and I'm definitely going to water down the black because it will flow a little bit further. And I'm just going to start kind of going. When I outline, I try to keep it loose and not necessarily covering every single inch. That way you don't have to be perfect with it. And you still get that same effect. And I'm going to kind of just do a loose little outline there at the bottom. I'm going to go ahead and can go ahead and paint in the string. Just want it to connect . You can take a piece of chalk too and kind of rough in an outline for this, keep you on track. Fill in those little cracks. So I'm also going to like put the string, now we're gonna go over the top of this and then behind this one. And I'm gonna bring it. The string dangling there. I'll have to go back and erase that chalk after the painting's dry. I tend to use my pinky to keep my hand off the, from dragging across the paint. Trying to cover up the chalk if I can. Oops, I'll get a little bit of red there. I'll go ahead and swish there in the little snow hill. You could also add a few little random little swishes at the base. I'm going to move my paint palette here. So I'm going to lay this flat for this last little bit. We're doing his mouth, and I just water down the black, and I start over here. And then I'm going to go ahead and outline his little stick hands. A few swishes on the top of his head. I kind of like to throw out some little swishes for the feathers here and there. kind of step back and see if there's any areas that you might want to go back over. Now I'm going to take a piece of chalk, as long as this is dry, and I'm going to do like a very soft line for the lettering. And I kind of designed this so that none of the lettering would be on the crack. And I'm going to go back to my I'm going to use my small round brush for the lettering. And I, with the lettering, I tend to do that laying flat on the table. I'm going to And because I'm left-handed and I tend to smear things, I'm going to start at this end. Got water in my brush. I don't like that. I'm going to dry that out. Now I'm going to mix up just a little bit of orange for their beaks, because that looks like it's dry. Which I did that by adding some red and yellow together. I'm going to scoop in a little bit of white. The white definitely helps it cover better. And I'm trying not to smear anything. Just kind of push. And just bring it to a point. I think this might need a second coat too. And then I'm going to take the back of my brush, dip it into the white, and I'm just going to add a little dot for his eye. Then I'm going to wipe that off, and I'm going to go in with a little dot of black. Just kind of stick it on the side. Go ahead and I just was looking at this. I think I'm just going to add like a loose little outline around that since I left the dark edges. Kind of adds a little more dimension if you want. It absolutely does not have to be perfect. And then I just do another quick little and a second coat of that orange. now we got, he is pretty much done. I might go back and add, let's see, some light pink. Ah, don't drop your brush. Knowing when to stop is huge too. It's like sometimes you can, if you're starting to question whether you're done, you should stop, because you can definitely overwork a painting. I've done it many times. I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick little outline on his their nose so it stands out a little. And then with the snowman and the holiday paintings, one of my most favorite parts is I'm going to take a fan brush. You can use a toothbrush, but the fan brush works the best for me. And I'm gonna scoop out some white. Move this out of the way. And I'm just gonna water down some white. And then I'm gonna lay my painting flat. I'll move this out of the way so I don't knock it over. I'm gonna lay the painting flat. See if I can do it like this so you can see it. So I'm just gonna fill up my brush with the white, the watered down white, and then you're just gonna hold it over, and you find a heavy instrument, and then you just start tapping, and it creates snow, and it just looks so cool. It's such a simple thing, but everybody loves it. Tuck your shoes under a table if you're doing this, because it does kind of go everywhere sometimes. Dump that in my water, and there you go. You got a cute little Valentine's Day snowman. Oops, I got some paint down there, but I'll clean that up after class. I hope that you guys, let's see if we're back. I hope that you guys enjoyed doing this cute little painting, and I hope that you will join me with some of the other ones I start doing in March. And if you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate it if you would hit the share button. I would love to reach more people. So if you have any questions, just ask them on this video. Thank you, everyone, and I hope you guys have a great weekend.